欢迎回来，来看其他方面的消息。随着网络流媒体的发展，不同商家都推出了各式各样的月费套餐，用平台独有的一些电影、电视剧产品吸引消费者的注意。但一些专家提醒民众，事实上市场上仍然存在着一些不需要支付高昂的月费，也可以观看大量影视剧产品的方式。虽然他们侧重于比较旧的节目，但依然可以满足许多类型观众的需求。
Tired of paying subscription fees for a streaming service to watch movies? Well, there are plenty of places where you can find movies for free. The catch is, some also have ads. But if you're interested in saving money, everything from Sony Crackle to Vudu and Pluto TV offer free options. Consumer Reports recently looked at your free options and listed the pros and cons of the main ones. The service called Hoopla requires just a library card to get free movies, music, and audiobooks. Upon checking out a movie, you'll have 72 hours.To watch it. IBD TV is an ad-supported service owned by Amazon. The free service focuses on older movies and TV shows, but deals were just struck with a number of entertainment studios, and the amount of content available on the service is expected to triple. Sony has an ad-supported free service called Crackle, which offers popular older TV shows and movies. And Vudu is Walmart's online video site. The service has a free section where it offers movies and TV shows at no cost.For a complete rundown of how to watch what you want without paying anything, check out the full story at consumerreports.org.
随着科技的发展，高新设备不断普及和快速更新换代，美国青少年沉迷在电子屏幕前的时间越来越长。根据最新的统计，平均一个8到18岁的美国青少年每天在电子屏幕前花费在社交媒体和娱乐上的时间超过7小时。对青少年的健康和成长可能已经产生了不利影响。健康专家指出，希望学校和家长方面提高监管力度，避免电子产品对孩子产生更大的影响。
More than 7 hours a day. That on average is how much time a U.S. teen spends watching a screen for entertainment, according to a new study by the nonprofit organization Common Sense Media. Researchers say screen time has inched up by 42 minutes a day since 2015.Data from a nationwide survey of more than 1,600 youth between the ages of 8 to 18 was analyzed. The study says tweens spend nearly 5 hours looking at screens. Most of the time in both age groups is spent looking at TV or videos. The research shows for tweens, YouTube dominates the online video space. Youth also spend a majority of time using devices to play games.Risks include the potential for youth to be exposed to harmful messages online and for them to become socially isolated, spending time on devices instead of with peers. For today's Health Minute, I'm Mandy Gaither.
再来看娱乐方面的消息，著名奇幻冒险系列《丛林大冒险》的最新续集日前曝光了一些新的片段和细节。有著名喜剧明星杰克·布莱克和巨石强森主演的这一系列影片受到了美国从老人到小孩广大观众群体的集体追捧。据制片方介绍，新的续集人们在剧情中的身份反转将爆发出新的碰撞和笑点，相信会不负众望。影片将在今年12月13日上映。
Are we in Florida?
Oh my God!
Wait,
we're in the wrong body.
My joints feel like butter.
Oh no! Here's a sneak peek at Jumanji: The Next Level, the sequel to the 2017 hit Jumanji: Welcome to the Jungle, reunites the cast, but does a bit of role swapping with Dwayne Johnson and Kevin Hart playing the Jumanji game avatars of Danny DeVito and Danny Glover. It's game on for Jumanji: The Next Level on December 13th.
I say hallelujah.
Casting news, Jeffrey Wright teams up with Batman. Director Matt Reeves announced via social media that Wright will play Commissioner Gordon in his upcoming film, The Batman. The movie stars Robert Pattinson as the Caped Crusader and is scheduled to hit theaters in June of 2021.
People call you a monster too. Why
I not kill them?
Because then I am what they say I am.
Netflix has released a first look at its upcoming series, The Witcher. Henry Cavill plays monster hunter Geralt of Rivia in a series based on The Witcher books by Andrzej Sapkowski. The Witcher storms onto Netflix December 20th. In Hollywood, I'm Rick Damigella.
本周最受关注的新片将是由施瓦辛格回归主演的著名科幻系列《终结者》的最新一部续集《终结者：黑暗命运》。本片不但由著名科幻电影大师詹姆斯·卡梅隆监制，由实力导演蒂姆·米勒执导，在剧情上也是《终结者2：审判日》的直接延续。相信这部全新的影片将会为全球观众带来更多人机大战惊喜，展示一场科幻狂潮。
I'll be back.
Linda Hamilton is back as Sarah Connor in Terminator Dark Fate. The sixth movie in the Terminator franchise is actually a timeline reset, taking place as a direct sequel to Terminator 2 Judgment Day and ignoring the events of the three previous sequels and the Sarah Connor Chronicles TV series. Deadline and Variety's prognosticators predict Dark Fate could open in the range of $40 million and potentially as high as $47 million.
August 29, 1997. It was supposed to be Judgment Day. But I changed the future.
Linda Hamilton is back as Sarah Connor in Terminator Dark Fate.
Because of the passage of time, I thought, well, she's got to have a new voice, and I knew that there would be a lot to mine from in the intervening 28 years.That I could stack up and bring to the set with me every day.
Dark Fate resets the Terminator movie timeline as a direct sequel to T2 Judgment Day, ignoring the previous sequels and TV series. The movie features a new duo of tough-as-nails women at its core.
For me, I mean, it was obviously a very physical role, so I did a lot of preparation in the gym, a lot of stunt training, did military training in Texas. Linda and I went on a little field trip together for a week.
I was not training as hard as Mackenzie. It was pretty intense physically, but also, you know, emotionally, you just need to be ready to face this 6 months of not sleeping so much and just being around all this pressure. So it was a lot, but it was amazing.
Expect a big pain, brother. Whole body's a weapon.
Gabriel Luna is a brand new Terminator threatening humanity's existence.
I did everything I could to analyze those first two films and truly honor the parts of Arnold's and Robert's performance that were affected, that generated the dread within me and that made them both so iconic.
I'll be back.
You have made it 100 miles to freedom all by yourself. Would you like to pick a new name to mark your freedom?
The historical biopic Harriet stars Cynthia Erivo as the former slave who became an abolitionist after escaping to freedom via the Underground Railroad. Deadline says Harriet could open to between $8 and $9 million, while Variety pegs it slightly higher at $10
million. I don't know if you know how extraordinary this is, but you have made it 100 miles to freedom all by yourself. Would you like to pick a new name to mark your freedom?
Harriet Tubman.
Tony winner Cynthia Erivo stars in Harriet as the escaped slave determined to free others from bondage.
God was watching, but my feet was my own. Running, bleeding, climbing, nearly drowned, nothing to eat for days and days, man. I made it. So don't you tell me what I can't do.
I'm a 5'1" woman, so I'm a small woman who understands what it is to be underestimated. And to be able to play her sort of taught me that I have much more power than I know.
To watch Cynthia portray this giant, this hero, you know, I could just cry thinking about it. Her selflessness, her fear, she is the epitome of what it means to be fearless.
It's the first time Tubman's story has been told on the big screen, though the script was written more than two decades ago.
I, for one, think it would have been relevant and timely and potent 20 years ago, be relevant 50, 100 years from now.
It wasn't that she was fearless.She could overcome it, you know? And that's what we need. That's a message that we need now. Our courage has to overcome our fear.
I would give every last drop of blood in my veins until this monster called slavery is dead.
But inside my head's an even bigger mess. I can't stop twisting things around.
Edward Norton wrote, produced, directed, and stars in Motherless Brooklyn. Deadline pegs the noir crime drama with a $5 to $6 million debut, while Variety places it in the $10 million range.
Swifty's the name. You're looking at the next lead dog for the Arctic Blast Delivery Service.
Starring the voices of Jeremy Renner, Heidi Klum, and John Cleese, the animated Arctic Dogs about a canine delivery service looks to mush its way to a $4 to $5 million debut, according to Deadline, with Variety sources saying it could dig up closer to $10 million. In Hollywood, I'm Rick Damigella.
感谢收看今天的汉天新闻，接下来请收看汉天生活报道。